In the forest farm, one of the important principles what is followed is to allow plenty of trees to exist inside the farm. So many times these trees, the seeds come on their own and they start germinating. And if we find such seedlings, particularly tree varieties are coming up, I leave them alone for a few years. And after they've grown up, if they're still inconvenient location, then we cut them up. Now this is a Pterocarpus marsupium, very important herb as well as timber tree of India. Famous tree, in fact, it was called as Malabar tree. Now this one has come on its own. It's come in my hedge area in the middle of the farm. So I'm going to allow it to stay. There is 1, 2, 3, 4 of them are born here, and they're about 4 years old now, 10 feet to 12 feet tall. Now, instead of allowing this tree to go waste, we have climbed the string beans onto it. This is a string bean. The string bean flower. Very pretty thing, purplish. And then these are the beans. Even the seeds are visible here. Now I'll be harvesting these seeds for planting. And then this bean is now beautifully climbing up onto the Pterocarpus. It's going up and using it as a staff to climb up. And see, these are the beans. And the little red, variety of red ants, is not the bigger one. They are guarding this one. So there are no aphids, there are no insect attacks. And it's climbing up there. And then there's one more baby here, see, flower with two baby beans. And he'll get probably about 200 or 250 grams of beans from this in the season. And while all that is happening, come back to the base. There's also sweet potato growing here. So if you have plenty of sweet potatoes here and there, they suppress the weeds. And if you are hungry and there is nothing in the kitchen, you can just stroll around the garden and dig out a few kilos of sweet potatoes and put them in a fire and make some nice roast sweet potato. So there is sweet potato, which is around a year, it gives us crops. And then string bean, both are climbing around and on to a Pterocarpus marsupium, which is a very valuable, rare, endangered, medicinal, high value timber tree of India. So all are useful and all are coexisting, and no disease on this bean. See, all leaves are healthy, and the beans also lie nice. See, lovely beans. So why should there's absolutely no logical reason to spray any idiotic pesticide onto these plants. The height of stupidity.